We had a call in regards to this client, a female girl that her family was feeling like she was not taking care of herself. She was not compliant with medication, and she was starting to struggle a little bit. So the family had actually talked with us in regards to how to get her into a facility where she could be assessed. We educated the family in regards to how Form 8 works in regards to mental health, and they went out and seek that through the courthouse. Myself and John apprehended the young lady and transported to the hospital. She understood why she was going there, and she did recognize that she needed help. So that was back about a few months ago, about 2 months ago. And now the family's got a couple concerns. We actually ran into her the other day when we were down at Canadian Mental Health because she is following through with some of the outsourced resourcing that the hospital provided her. But the family just has a couple questions and a couple things that they want to check on. So we'll be going to her residence and just doing a check-in, see how she's doing, and be able to provide her with some more resources or avenues of therapy or mental health, and just see how she's doing. So it'll be good to just do some follow-up here. And all we're gonna advise is that we stop by and that you seem better than before and that you're doing well. We're just here for you.
You don't have to tell them anything. You can phone us and say, hey, you know
Yep.
what? I've got some stuff going on.
Sure.
No, and you phone us and you know that. We have a pretty good rapport with you, right? And we can figure some stuff out. And if counseling ever doesn't work, maybe you need to be navigated to another
So
spot.
our RPAC stands for Regional Police and Crisis Team. It's a partnership between an RCMP officer and a mental health therapist. RPAC was created back in 2011, recognizing the need for a collaborative service responding to Albertans experiencing mental health crises.
Right now in Central Alberta, we just have the PAC team here in Red Deer servicing the citizens of Red Deer. So what it is, we work in partnership with Primary Care Network. They have a registered psych nurse alongside. So we have two teams, myself and another member. I have a nurse working with me, a registered psych nurse, and the other team has a registered psych nurse as well.
403.
We take lead on mental health calls, and we assist the community in dealing with these complex kind of nature calls. At the end of the day, police officers have a lot of hats to wear, and one of those, which is getting increasingly demanding on police officers, is the mental health aspect of things, right?
So my name is John Abelinas. I'm a registered psychiatric nurse with the Red Deer Primary Care Network. And as a psych nurse with the Red Deer PCN, we have a partnership with the Red Deer RCMP to be a mobile mental health crisis response team. So part of my job as a psych nurse is to do on-scene clinical assessments, mental status exams, and when a person's in crisis, and figure out what the best course of action is for that individual and the most therapeutic approach.
So when a police officer responds on their own to a mental health call, there's a lot of unknowns. So they often don't know the mental health history of this person. For instance, whether they have a diagnosis and are taking medication, things like that. They also simply don't have the expertise to conduct an accurate mental health assessment. And so having that partner there in those instances can really look at what's been going on for that person through their health history and how we can support them better.
And one of the benefits that I think we've seen throughout the time here is the ability for us to educate and work alongside the RCMP and do that on-site assessment where we can actually spend time with the individual. And if it has to be an hour, 30 minutes, 20 minutes, we can sit there, we can tease through the crisis, calm them down, figure out exactly where they're at, meet them where they're at, and have that discussion on how we can best help them in a non-judgmental way. I like to call it a therapeutic approach. But the benefit is that we have that time. We're able to relieve general duty members from the mental health calls and provide a clinical expertise to figure out exactly where that person is in their moment of mental health crisis. I think just having the knowledge of how actual mental disorder presents. A lot of people, you know, I'll ask lots of questions in my assessment, you know, have you ever been diagnosed with anything? I do have access to avenues that allow me to look up the individual to see what their past diagnoses are or if they've ever been in hospital before. And that's no different than working in a clinic or in the hospital or anything like that. And it's highly beneficial because if I've never dealt with the individual or it's a new person to me, to know that somebody's got a diagnosis of schizophrenia or depression or anxiety, it kind of helps. Or if there's any been violence before, or how they've acted, you know, in mental health care, it kind of helps prepare us you know, the flavors that we're going to hear in the discussion with me. And it helps us make a quicker assessment and be like, yep, that sounds exactly the same as their last hospital admission, or sounds a lot like their diagnosis, part and parcel. And just kind of, it really helps build a bigger picture to keep us safe, but not only us, but the individual as well. And that's the most important thing, is how can we do this most therapeutically for that individual? Because quite often there's a lot of fear when, you know, with police and the mental health and stuff like that. And that's what we're there to do, is keep that therapeutic approach.